Hello everybody, I forgot to make a video entry, so today I am going to be making smudge sticks for the very first time ever, and I'm taking you guys along with me to show you how I made my smudge sticks. I have seen other tutorials on YouTube, there's lots of tutorials on YouTube talking about what smudge sticks are, how to make them, and how to use them, and this is just a small version of how I did mine. So I hope you guys enjoy today's video, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Let me know in the comments how you feel about the video, and if you would like more videos like this one. Hello everyone, welcome back. It's the Ancient Gypsy YouTube channel. Today, I can pull them out of my pockets. We have a video. We're going to be making our own smudge sticks. Yay! Smudge sticks! Woo! Cleansing! We're just gonna put those there. Let's see. Alright, as you can see, I am dressed in white and yellow. White for purification, yellow for joy. Okay. So, I'm going to use some dragon's blood before we begin. And I'm going to use this for protection. This bundle here, this was a bundle I put up in my shower. It has Theme and Mint in it. It's a little bit dry now. It's only been in there for 2 days. I tied it with a shoelace just to hang it up in the shower, but I am now going to undo that carefully. It has used its use in a shower, and I would now like to add it to a sage bundle before it gets too, you know, used up. Another way you can discard of like your herbs once you're done using them is you can put them in a compost pile or tote or whatever. I'm going to be making a vlog where I show you how I'm going to set up my compost container, and I'm also going to be going over like just different ways, or not really different ways, but I'm going to be making a vlog on it. Vlog on like how I start my compost container, how it goes for me, all that good stuff. Let's see. I don't know if I want to use this one. So this is patchouli. Patchouli will add magic to, will add power to any magic you use. This one is called Love Spell. I don't know. What do I want to use? I don't know where my incense container went now. Gucci gang. Alright, handy dandy matches. Because you definitely always need matches in your altar. Because you will lose a lighter at some point and need to light a candle or an incense. Those ones are empty. This bucket has soil in it. That's why I'm using it. Because you can't burn soil. The candle I'm lighting over here is a protection candle. Okay, I think we're almost ready. I don't have any scissors today, so we're just gonna trim my string using a flame. Okay, so I'm gonna try to show you this the best I can. Mint. Okay, I got some mint, sage. Sage cleanses away all energy, good or bad. Mint invites abundance, health, and prosperity. So this is what a fresh fresh sage leaf looks like. So that's one that's not dried out. These I bought from my local grocery store. So I got these from a family fair. Basil, prosperity, peace, love, and harmony. Okay, last little thing of basil. Oh, it smells so good. I love basil. And thyme for balance, peace, love, prosperity, inner peace, and did I already say balance? Balance to the rest of what I'm adding to this sage bundle. And it just smells really good. Invites money, all that good stuff. So that's what that looks like. Okay, then you're just gonna get them all kind of together like I have here. And then you're gonna begin to wrap it. I'm making sure I get the bottom nice and tight and good, and then going up to the top, making sure I get everything nice and tight. I might even need another string. I hope not. Man, this smells so good. It's like very earthy, very fresh, almost florally. Almost smells like flowers. It definitely smells like spring. It's kind of got a nice musk to it. I wish you guys could smell this. Okay. So, I've tied it once. I'm going to tie it a couple of times just to be sure. Actually, I'm going to use white. White and black are protective colors. So, they're a good base color for anything you're doing in witchcraft or any kind of spiritual work you're doing, any kind of protective or cleansing work. What does she match? Okay, I guess I'm not using white. Fine, I'll use black. I don't have any scissors, so I'm just cutting it with my candle flame. And I'm gonna add in a stick of a stick of cinnamon for abundance. I'm gonna pick the skinnier one here. It is kind of hard once you get to the end to hold a grip on it, as you can see me struggle. You may even want to like pull on your strings a little bit to make sure that they're all nice and tight. I'm double knotting here. I'm going to use a rubber band on the end of this. Whoops, not that one. I wouldn't burn it with the rubber band because the rubber band's just going to fall off. I don't even know if the string is good enough to burn it with. But we're making our own sage bundles. Yeah, our own smudge sticks. Ooh, it came out super cute. Look at it. So it's got a lot of abundance, peace, prosperity, all that good stuff that you want brought into the home. Cinnamon can also be used for protection, so you can sage, protect, and then with the mint and basil, invite abundance and peace and love and prosperity. And then theme balances all of this out so that the energy is nice and balanced. It works nice together. There's no conflictions, and you have every piece of element you need when you're saging or bringing new energy into the home. Sage alone will cleanse away all energy, good or bad, doesn't matter. So when you sage, you definitely need to have something to burn afterwards, or have something to invite the energy you desire in to your home or space afterwards. So I might burn some cinnamon sticks, or I might burn some abundance sage, or not abundance sage, some abundance incense, or Palo Santo, because Palo Santo is very protective. Or I might burn like a myrrh or myrrh. I'm not sure how you say it. It's like M-Y-R-H. And some people spell it M-Y-R-T-H. So it's like myrrh or myrrh.
and frankincense burn, and that's because those are two of the things that were brought to Jesus by the wise men, and they're burned in churches. They're very, like, pure incense. They're very holy incense, so I bring, like, the spirit of Christ into my house after I sage. I bring, you know, I'll bring abundance into the home, I'll bring love into the home, and I'll try to do something to bring the spirit of Christ, God, our Lord and Savior, into my home, because I am Christian, I'm Southern Baptist, but I'm not necessarily what most Christians tend to be. I practice witchcraft. I'm bisexual. So, I'm not what most Christians would think a good Christian should be, but I don't think God judges me. Me and God have a very good relationship, and I'm not ashamed. He knows who I am, I know who he is. We're all good and Gucci in the world. Anyway, I'm gonna quit rambling so much. Here is my finished sage stick. This is probably still too fresh to light on fire, so I'm gonna hang it upside down, let it dry out, probably hang it in my window even, and voila, sage stick. I don't think I'll be able to hang up this string. But I do have some of these Christmas bulb hooks. These are little hooks you put on Christmas bulbs. So you see what I did there? I just kind of closed that little hooky part on the end. I'm going to hang it up in my window, and then I'll show you in a moment. So the lighting isn't necessarily great because I have the window right behind it, but that's how I hooked it up there. It's hanging on some string.
Okay, so
and that is how we made
sage bundle.
Yay! What we have left, we are out of basil. Basil is empty. We have some mint left. We have some thyme left. We have sage. And some bay leaves from my spiritual bath. Some thyme. And maybe even some basil from my spiritual bath that I'm going to add into this. So we're just going to get it all in our container again. Okay. This is the last bundle of sage. So as I put it in here and I'm adding more pieces together, I'm kind of pinching it together. Try to do it up here so you can see better. Boom! So I folded that in half. I'm gonna add it in with the bay leaves and the sage and the other thing. Okay, it doesn't work folded in half. It doesn't seem to want to do its thing. And the bay leaves keep falling out, so I might have to add those at the end. little bit more time to this. That's all we have left of the theme. And we're going to add some mint. One little piece of mint left. Sage and basil are gone. Here it is. See, that's why you don't really want to use a candle to cut your string, because it might catch on fire. I have to bring this down here to tie it. I can't tie it up here. It's not a loose sage bundle. You want to tie it as tight as possible. Squeeze them as much as possible. Make sure you don't catch yourself on fire. Because you gotta think, you're gonna be walking around your home or your space burning this when it's dry. So you don't want anything falling out, catching anything on fire. You don't want to burn yourself, and you don't want your sage stick to fall apart while you are smudging your space. So you want to make sure you fit it as tight as possible. Yet I need another piece of string. This one doesn't want to stay very tight, so I'm putting multiple strings on it. Be careful if you do that. You know, just watch your string. Watch your smudge stick when you're burning, you know, a smudge stick. When you're cleansing your space, if you're using fire at all, please be mindful of fire safety. Please do not catch your home, or yourself, or your possessions on fire. Okay, and I'm going to go in with a little bit of thread too, just to be sure. I'm going to tie it in like two or three different spaces, just because I want to be sure.
wanna be a great one. I wanna be a great one. I wanna make a million dollars, making all my days count, counting with my day ones. Before I hit the graveyard, Louis V don't chase no. I wanna make a billion dollars, bring it to my pop, say daddy, what you crave?
That is the second finished Smudge stick. Thank you guys so much for being here today. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Continue to help support this channel. Continue to like the videos you want to see more of. Comment what kind of videos you want to see more of. Comment how you took today's video. Did you like it? Did you dislike it? Is there things you would change about it? Is there something different I could do to help you guys out more? Until next time, guys, love yourself and your world. Have a great day.